Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 90th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 633. The booster which launched this mission, B1077, then landed successfully for the ninth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
There's no video of it, but on Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 91st mission of the year with Starlink 78. The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Today or tomorrow, depending on your time zone, SpaceX were planning to launch a Falcon Heavy rocket. SpaceX posted some information to confirm that this Falcon Heavy launch has been delayed by 24 hours. It says, now targeting Monday, December 11th for Falcon Heavy's launch of the USSF 52 mission with weather conditions forecasted to improve to 70% favorable for liftoff on Monday night. The team will use the time to complete additional pre-launch checkouts. Later today or tomorrow, depending on your time zone, we could also see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 634 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 11th at 4 a.m. UTC, or today, Sunday 10th at 11 p.m. EST. Then, as mentioned by SpaceX, we can hopefully expect to see a Falcon Heavy mission later in the day tomorrow or early Tuesday morning. The Falcon Heavy mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 12th at 1:14 a.m. UTC or Monday 11th at 8:14 p.m. EST. Then, again, later in the week, we could expect to see another customer mission launch. The Ovzon 3 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 14th at 9 p.m. UTC or 4 p.m. EST. There was an article posted related to Starlink testing. It says, SpaceX's Starlink satellite service successfully completed 9 months of US military tests in the Arctic. There was an article posted about SpaceX selling shares and raising the company value. It says, SpaceX has initiated discussions about selling insider shares at a price that values the closely held company at $175 billion or more, according to people familiar with the matter. Jared Isaacman posted some interesting information about Polaris Dawn. His first post says, I am at SpaceX today for EVA suit testing. This is an evolution of the dev suits. Suit pics will be released in advance of mission, but I don't know when. Around April is the goal to launch and the pace of training is accelerating. In response, somebody posted, if April is the goal to launch, then Polaris Dawn is still constantly being delayed per every 3 months for another 3 months. Jared responded with, it's a development program with ambitious objectives. Schedule slips should be expected. He was then asked, good to know, however, with the basic hardware being available, Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon 1 wonders what's taking so long. Would be grateful to learn what's the main reason, spacesuit readiness, training issues, scheduling with higher priority missions, all of these? His response was, building and certifying new EVA suits for starters. There is a big difference between an IVA suit that is the last line of defense in a vehicle versus suit engineered from the start to be exposed to vacuum outside the spaceship. That includes suit changes for mobility, life support redundancy, sunglass and resilience to MMOD. Similarly, the vehicle was designed to go to vacuum only in an emergency. There are changes to software and EC/LSS hardware to make an EVA a nominal operation. Laser-based communication over the Starlink constellation is not an easy task either. It's not just turning the router switch to the on position. Every Draco firing could break a link. We are flying higher and closer to the Van Allen belts than anyone has gone since Apollo 17. The radiation exposure during those orbits over a few days is equivalent to months on the ISS. Avionics don't like radiation, which means there is a lot to analyze and sim to get right. SpaceX engineers are doing an outstanding job tackling big problems very quickly. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. The chopsticks were recently seen raised to the top of the tower. Work continues on the orbital tank farm expansion. This new booster work stand has been seen being worked on. the container wall that was damaged during the second flight test is being demolished. Windows have started being installed at the top of the Mega Bay 2 building. This mystery concrete structure has been spotted being constructed. Apparently, the GAO is pushing the FAA to improve its mishap investigation process to speed up investigations. On Thursday, SpaceX posted a super cool video of Starship's second integrated flight test. They said at dawn from the gateway to Mars, the launch of Starship's second flight test. The hot staging ring was recently seen installed atop Booster 10. Booster 10 has also been moved over to the rocket garden as it awaits rollout for testing. To finish up the video today, we'll take a look at the Cameron County website. There is currently a temporary road closure scheduled for today, Sunday 10th. Then they also have possible closures for tomorrow, Monday 11th and Tuesday 12th. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.